What I'm going to show you today, and it's not just me who says this, is the eighth wonder of the world. And for £11.50 each, you can't say further than that, can you? Passing now through some important landmarks in his life. Mandarin Palace on your right, Chinky Restaurant, where he was first introduced to his favourite takeaway. For the record, that was Shanghai black bean chicken with eggy fried rice. Scissors, receptionist there has six fingers on her hand. What about that, Nana? We can pop in there on the way back if you like.
What's going on?
Do you know who I think looks shiftiest today?
Me?
Yeah.
I haven't got nothing to worry about.
Excuse me, at the house, after song, we can touch?
Yes, it's all included in 11.50.
Yeah.
It's only me, Georgie. Excuse me, love.
Ooh.
Now then, ladies and gentlemen, international guests, two nations, former enemies, united today by one man. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Valmore Productions, I present to you the fattest man in Britain, Mr. Georgie Godwin.
I've got your picture. I've got your picture. I'd like a million of them all right myself. I want the doctor to take your picture so I can look at you from inside as well. You got me turning up and turning down and turning in and turning round. I'm turning Japanese, I think I'm turning Japanese, I really think so. I'm turning Japanese, I think I'm turning Japanese, I really think so. And then you will come and all ask shalom. Hello.
Hello.
I'm Georgie Godwin, fattest man in Britain.
Guaranteed, and the only one that sings.
Now, I've spotted you Japanese, so first things first. Arigato gozaimasu. There you go. You ask me anything you want. Anything.
She says, you're very big.
Oh, you won't get bigger than Georgie, love. And if anybody tells you that Tommy Stafford from Burnley is bigger than him, they're talking out their arsehole.
He says, can he touch now?
Yes, it's all included. But I would ask you to respect Georgie's private zones, health and safety.
Morris.
Whoa, Nana, whoa, Nana. Come on, we don't want to lose you, do we? Gently. Come on, Tokyo Joe, don't milk it. Now, you're probably wondering, should I tip in dollars or pounds? Can I be cheeky with the exchange rate and everything and say pounds? As a guy, 20. That's the purple one, Nana. Now, do you want to go back into town or to the hotel?
Thank you, Mr. Georgie. You sing beautiful.
Hiya,
4 hours. I'll be up. She's only a little lass. After the performance, she came up to me and touched my hand, just gentle, and said, "Thank you, Georgie."
Aww.
It was moments like that, Janice, that made me realise why I'm in the entertainment industry. They were gorgeous, them chops, Janice. Thank you.
Good.
I'm sorry, love. But I'm afraid it's Vianetta again. Oh, look how white that sand is, Georgie. I wonder how they get it so white.
It's Mauritius.
Have we been here before?
Probably the last place in the Indian Ocean we've not been to. Shall I pop us on to verify?
Oh, yes.
Madeira? Been there. Madagascar? Been there. Mauritius. A thoroughly enjoyable visit. There. Verified. Hey, I got a letter today from social services.
You never went all the way down the hallway. Why didn't you wait for me? I'd have picked it up for you, Georgie, love.
No. I fancied a stroll. Anyway, they're only sending me a problem teenager to community service me garden.
A problem teenager? Does it say what the problem is?
Well, there's two shopping trolleys out there. That'll be his first problem. And it doesn't matter how I try. My tears are always high. If I turn away, am I strong enough to see it through? Going crazy is what I will do. If I can't have you, I don't want nobody, baby. If I can't have you, All right, Nana, is he in? All right, my bub.
All right, Morris.
When are you going to come and see Georgie? He'd love to see you. And remember, our price Sundays.
Fuck off, Morris.
Hello, Mr. Morris.
Come on, hurry up, Raj. Or I'll go to Tesco's where you can be sure of your sell-bys. Fill her up. Now then. Our Georgie took a sudden dislike to Vianetta's.
Really?
Nothing sinister. He said it's a case of familiarity breeding contempt. Instead of Vianetta's, he said he'd like to try this Agandazi. What's a tub of that?
£3.85.
Shove the Vianetta's in.
Quavers expired only 3 months. Completely safe. Daughter tested.
Bung them in. What's the latest sales figures on the T-shirt?
Nana? Oh, buddy, I didn't the T-shirt. Can you bitch?
Ek bhi nahi bitch. Bahut kharab.
Ek bhi nahi. Hi, hi. Neil.
Well, you're not promoting them right. You've got to get them out there, because they'll sell as sure as I've all in me.
Spin me right round, baby, right round, like a wrecker, baby, round.
Hiya, Morris.
Right round. There he
comes. You're right.
You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a wrecker, baby, right round. You spin me right round, baby, right round.
Now then, cock. What do you think of that? I've had some printed up. Flying off Raj's shelves like hotcakes. What's the face on for?
I don't like them touching. You know that.
Hey, don't come the temperamental diva with me. I'll tell you what, Janice. Two-ton Tobin staff has let him touch him up for 6 months now.
Well, he would.
We've got to compete, Georgie. There's a lot more fat fuckers around now than when you started off.
I don't like my audience touching me. That's all I'm saying.
Any road. I've got an out down for you tomorrow morning, but I've got an heavy pencil on two Saudis at 3:30. Then you've got somebody in at 5:30. No, sorry. That's Valerie's smear test. Right? I'll love you and leave you. Me and Valerie are going over to Ralph and Nikita's tonight. She's had underfloor eating installed.
Ooh, underfloor eating.
Where's your tuck tonight?
Hey, you've not heard the latest. She only had to wax his back, neck to crack, 2:20 in the morning.
He's a lucky sod, that tuck. My Valerie won't even pull me hers out of the plug hole.
Don't forget, Janice, put that food in the freezer.
Bye, Morris.
I bet he never got me any Haagen-Dazs.
Yes, I've seen a rainbow, and I felt the rain. Woke up to a sunrise, and I felt the pain. I've seen it all somehow. Let's just look at us.
Of baby Daniel.
Not a chance.
But this is not going to happen.
No, it's not.
We just want to all stop all the texts and everything. No more texts. When you talk, all involved.
But there's right.
Well, don't tell us. Then
we will work out whether it is you go that way, you go that way, or there is any common ground by which this child, frankly, this is the worst thing about this story.
Ooh.
A 2-year-old, I hope to God she never sees this. All of you have family.
Oh, for Christ's sake, do a DNA and let's have done.
Now, you say that... Let's do those DNA results, because that's what we came for. Now, you say that only when you split with him did you have sex with 3 other men. He is aware of that. You're cool with that? You say you're 100% sure. You say you're 1,000% sure. How sure are you, Zuma? 100%. Yeah. Now, you, on the other hand, said, I'm only really 50.
Dan said he is not the father, and then she changed his name, he is the father. So it's your own fault people got doubts.
Long relationship with him lasting 168 hours. She said that she's 100% sure that.
Insurance from Aviva for life's little dramas.
At Asda, we're so proud of our Christmas food, we invited an independent panel of chefs to have a taste. They recommended our extra special party food, our succulent extra special Norfolk bronze turkey, and our extra special Belgian chocolate and raspberry bomb. That's extra special.
I think there's a bit of Portuguese in her or something, with all that black hair.
She's a pretty little thing. Dead cheerful. Always gives me a smile when I walk past.
There's nothing of her. What would you say? 6.5? 7? 7.3?
I'd have said 7.4. No, go on. 7.3.
She's very petite. Like a little bird. But she's a grafter.
Georgie, just turn your face that way, will you, for me?
Yesterday, she got that mobile for 18 minutes, but the whole time her other little hand was still weeding.
Oh, well, shit.
She didn't even take them shopping trolleys back to Summerfield.
No. Now, 10 minutes. This time I'm going to use the timer.
Whoa, don't waste it. There's a couple of sausage rolls over here doing nothing.
Now, you know what, Georgie? People would never believe just how much work goes into you. There we are. You're a stalker.
Do you know, every morning at 11:20, she sits on that rucksack and has a Snickers?
Does she?
This week, Monday, 11:20, a Snickers. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, 11:20, a Snicker. Well, blow me, Janice. Guess what she did this morning?
I don't know.
11:20, she goes into that little rucksack and what's she pull out? Only a crunchy.
Does she?
So I'm sat here trying to puzzle it out. Is there any significance in the Friday? Religion or something like that? Everything went through my mind. Well, bugger me. 5 to 4. What does that little minx bring out of that rucksack? A Snickers. Honestly, every day, a different story. Bloody hell, Janice. Look how much to Riley's yucca plants grow. Hey, they're like a wire over there.
So I couldn't get the fucking thing, yeah?
I have a fucking...
Listen!
You fucking...
Give me a second!
There's no television then, Ben, because you're not
going to
get
anything. Hey, 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 hey! Fucking God! Fuck off!
Hey, bloody bastard! Bloody night!
What is that? Deal with you later.
Hello, love. Amy, ain't it? I'm Georgie Godwin, the fattest man in Britain. Come and sit yourself down here now. Come on. Thank you. Go on. Oh. There you go. Can I get you anything? Tea and onion pasta? Sausage roll? Jumbo? Let me tell you what's been going on. You see Shane with the teeth? Well, he's brought up little Paris, thinking he was the dad of it. Anyhow, Shane's had to go to Edgbaston for work, carpet fitter by trade. And see him there, him here, with all the bling there, yeah? Jazzy D. Well, he's saying that little baby Paris is his. Are you with me, Amy? Well, when Shane was away, Jazzy D has fornicated with Paris's mother, Chelsea. And you know what put the lid on it for me, Amy? I bet they did it on one of Shane's bloody carpets, but he fitted himself. That's a dirty trick, isn't it, Amy, eh? And Jeremy's right. Why should I pay taxes if I did pay taxes? Just for it all to go up and smoke with Jazzy D.
I'm pregnant.
Paris's father that. Is Jazzy D. Easy.
Oh, bugger me. It was Jazzy D's. Poor little Paris.
You told me you pulled out.
Well, congratulations. That's smashing news. Yeah. Well, I'll tell you this. If you're as good at looking after a babby as you are my garden, you're laughing. Hey, oh, look at that. Hey, hey, hey. Kew Gardens. Ha ha. Now then. Little Pop Tart.
Ensure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life. We commend to Almighty God our brother Thomas Stafford, also known as Two-Ton Tommy.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was a hot like me? Don't you wish your girlfriend was a Greek like me? Don't you? Don't you wish your girlfriend was a wrong like me?
On Jesus, the protector and pioneer of our faith. Hear us as we offer with death in the power of the Spirit.
Taking a shot at the graveyard and then.
Bloody hell, they're milking it, Valerie. They've got television cameras here. Big crowd of people. All right, my bub. What a circus, eh?
Apparently, Stan Boardman's supposed to be coming.
The Holy Spirit. I'll tell you this, Valerie. With all due respect, rest in peace and all that. There's no way that fat dead fucker is fatter than my George.
Well, Burnley hasn't seen many send-offs quite like this one. As you can see,
we commit his oversized body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
So bold, Joyce. What in fact was his last meal?
Funny enough, he'd gone off his food at the end. The only thing he had that day were a double Rogan Josh and a beef biryani.
Well, I bet right now the blessed St. Peter is up there to frost and a leg of lamb for him.
What a lovely thought, Father.
Well, Joyce, in my prayers this morning, I warned God to expect a big one. Jesus Christ. Here he is now. There he is.
Easy,
to me!
Father!
He doesn't want to go, Joyce, does he? Bastard! Here, roly-polies, come on! He's your brother, put him in a waiting list! Come on! All together, 1, 2, 3, hop! Hold hands, we get in the middle. 1, 2, 3, hop!
Sorry about your loss, Miley. It was your biggest turn to Tommy, wasn't it?
Still.
One door shuts, another one opens. I'm fielding offers from our Georgia, left, right and centre.
Yeah, I heard about the T-shirt. Richard! Thanks, Richard! Richard Barter. He's doing a bit of a special on Tommy on the news tonight. Local legend sort of thing.
Oh, thank you for everything you've done for our Tommy, Morley. You've come to do more.
You're welcome, Joyce. Something's very close to my heart. Sorry about your loss, Joyce.
Oh, thanks, love. What, are you still representing Georgie Godwin, Maurice?
Sole representation, yeah.
Only we've got trunks full of Tommy's clothes, haven't we? And Vi said, they won't fit anybody else. And we're going to get a skip, weren't I? And I thought, what about your Georgie having them?
Oh, that's a lovely offer, Joyce. Oh. And I'd like to say a big thank you on behalf of our Georgie. Oh. But there's one reason I can't accept those clothes. They'd be too tight for him.
Tears and sandwiches were in order today at the Burnley funeral of Britain.
Is it on yet?
You're starting!
Tommy, two-turn at Stafford.
There she is. The Linda Lasardi of Chapel Street.
Richard Barter was there.
You've not missed anything.
You'll have one of these, won't you, Georgie?
No, not
Shut up, will you?
He hasn't seen many send-offs quite like this one. As you can see, behind me are hundreds of mourners, all here to say goodbye to one of the region's most colourful figures, Tommy Two-Ton Stafford.
There I am, look! That's me! Yes, look, you can see me, Luton!
Get out of the way!
A former dinner lady. And adding a touch of celebrity to the proceedings, amongst the condolence cards was one believed to have been from comedian Stan Boardman.
Oh, Stan Boardman.
Tommy rose from obscurity to eat his way into the record books as becoming Britain's biggest.
Well, that's bollocks.
At his peak, he was believed to have weighed in excess of 50 stones.
Bollocks.
Tommy was a giant of a man.
Bollocks!
He was also known for having a giant heart, which, sadly, gave out last Tuesday. Claire.
When I was at GK Morley's on Ashcroft Road and they weighed me on the thing, what they weighed the vans on, I was 53.5 stone.
Yeah, but that was over 20 years ago,
and there were Cliffy Proudfoot there, Shaky Dave and Eileen Upcook from the canteen with the raised shoe, and they'll verify that. Well, with the exception of Cliffy Proudfoot, who's since expired, but there's nothing I can do about that.
What are you getting all worked up about? Come on, Georgie. You're number one now. No question.
I just don't like lies. RIP and all that. But it were all girth with Tommy. With me, you get the density. God rest his soul, but Tommy Stafford was an out-and-out con artist. That should have been my funeral. Rolls are a star-bought woman. You make me sing like a guitar humming. Hang on to me, girl, our song keeps running on. Play it now, play it now, play it now, my baby.
Stop, 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 stop. Play it when? Now. Neil's not saying play it tomorrow or a week on Wednesday. He's saying play it when?
Now.
Right now, Georgie. That's got to be the attitude, Cox. Otherwise, it's all meaningless.
Play it now, my baby.
Oh.
Oh, so what's with the Neil Diamond then?
We're in the big time, Janice.
Oh,
we've got to cut classic.
Yeah.
With Tommy out of the way, there's going to be advertising, sponsorship.
Who was that, Georgie?
Hey, maybe it's already started. Maybe it's Hagen Dazzy come round with an offer. What about that? Georgie Godwin, the face of Hagen Dazzy.
What
happened, love? Bloody hell.
Amy, look at your little face.
I'm so sorry, I had nowhere else to go.
Was it that fella I saw you with?
Yeah. He's been on the smack all day and I could tell by his eyes when he come in. He wanted more money and I never had any and he said he was going to kick that baby out of me. He started kicking me and punching me. Wouldn't stop him. I had to get away from him.
God, that's him. Right.
Janice! Janice, love! Janice! Step back. Hey, leave this with me.
You can get out here, you slug! Now!
Yeah, I think it's him.
Hey, mate! I know you're fucking in there!
She's not here!
You can fucking get out here! Now then, Cox, best thing you can do, with all due respect, is fuck off.
What are you going to do about it, you fucking dwarf?
What?
You prick!
There's a 50-stone man in here who would like nothing better than to sit on you.
Emma! You can fucking get out of here, slug!
There you go.
One, to see you!
Amy, I've sorted it. He'll not be back now.
Sorry.
You've got nothing to be sorry for.
Amy, you are not going back there tonight.
You don't understand. I've not got nowhere else to go.
As Jeremy Kyle says, Amy, you shouldn't stay in an abusive relationship.
I'll tell you what, my Valerie has driven me ragged, but never once have I hit her. Fair enough, the odd V sign behind her back, and once, under duress, I used a flannel on my ass.
That's better, Amy. What about your mum and dad? Can't you go to them? Well, haven't you got any friends that you can stay with?
Not really. They're all his friends.
Well, you got friends here. You're stopping with me tonight. I mean it. You're to stop here. Away from that bullet boy, Oddie!
Right. That's settled, then. I'd best be off. Right, Amy, I don't want any arguing. I want you to take this. And I want to hear no more about it. Normally, the 10 quid. But under the circumstances, you give me 8 whenever you can.
You're not paying nothing.
We'll sort something out. I'll see you all tomorrow. Amy, you're safe now. You couldn't have a bigger bodyguard, could you?
Bye, Morris.
Bye.
Come on, love, I'll show you where you sleep.
No, Georgie, love, I'll show her.
I'm fine, I can manage.
No, let me show her. Oh, it's so much.
You get home. Go on, she'll be all right in a minute.
But what about the winter?
Oh, we saw that in the morning, no problem, don't worry. Come on, get home.
Oh, Amy, love, I would stay, only I've got the Turk coming round.
Go on, Janice, she'll be fine with me. I'll look after
her. Right. Night, love.
Thank you. Come on. Follow me. Follow me, darling. very special room, Aherne. This was my mum's room. She only took up half that bed. She could have had a cot, to be honest. She was like a little Russian doll. You know, the smallest one in the middle. I don't come in here much. When I do, it's like she's still here. It's like I can still see her. I can still hear her. Still smell her. Get some sleep now. Look after that babby. Yeah? No, it's all right. No, I can manage. I've got it.
Night, Georgie, and thank you.
Night, love. My mum will be looking down on you tonight. That was the bed she died in. No, no.
Rushing round in circles to brighten all the corners. Busy making friends with all your enemies. Finger through your Bible while looking through your window. The look you gave erased a thousand memories. Ooh, I'm sorry. Ooh, I am sorry. This page in your story won't.
Come on, Charlie.
Come in.
Who am I to ask you why? Feel the way you do. If you feel the way you do.
Cup of tea for you.
Is there nothing we could do?
What was that film star you got on your shirt there, Aherne?
Oh. I'm so sorry about last night.
Done and dusted, love.
Looking at your photos.
Oh.
Is that your mum?
That's my little mum.
She was tiny, wasn't she?
Size 2 feet, Aherne. She used to make these huge big meals. She'd have none for herself, it were all for me. And I'd eat it for her, and she'd give me this lovely big smile.
So is that how you got to be biggish?
Oh, no. In them days, I could still tie my own shoelaces. It was after Mam died it started. I came home that night from the funeral. It wasn't till I ate everything in that fridge that I could stop crying. It was like I was eating for her. It was as if there was an angel on my fork.
Thanks for putting me up, Mam. Better be going now, Georgie.
Where to? I thought so. Right, you are stopping here until you get yourself sorted.
I can help out. I can cut hair. I used to know everybody's at the foster home. I could do some decorating for you, if you like. Good at decorating.
Can you cook? Well, then, get in that kitchen and start decorating a frying pan with a bit of bacon. 4 eggs, sausages, tomatoes, beans, chips, mushrooms, hash browns and all the trimmings. Hey, there's no rush. Take me a while to get back to my chair.
It's not for anybody here on this show to influence anybody. We put the facts, we try and help resolve conflict. You say, if Dan... here today for a third time has cheated.
Show you today, and it's not just me who says this, is the eighth wonder of the world.
Her name is Rio and she dances on the sand, just like that river twists across a dusty land. And when she shines, she really shows you all you can. Oh, Rio, Rio, danced across the Rio Grande.
Bienvenue, welcome and hola shalom. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
I am Georgie Godwin, the fattest man in Britain.
Guaranteed.
Now then, Brazil. Population, 186 million. That's including you five. Brazil is primarily known for coffee, nuts and harbouring great chain robbers. But fair dues, you have won the World Cup five times, so it's not all bad, is it?
George, oh, gordinho, fofinho, fofinho.
Lo siento.
Vamos, dança samba. La 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 la.
Come on now. Just one little go. Don't take the piss, love.
The central part of the Sahara is...
That new conditioner's really made a difference, Georgie. The northern
and southern... Well, that'll be the jojoba.
...the highlands have areas of sparse grassland and desert shrub, with trees and taller shrubs in wadis...
They disrespected you today.
To the north...
Who?
The them Brazilians.
They all paid.
It was horrible. They're more touching you like that.
Well, I'm providing a service, aren't I, Amy? Oh, big lizard there, Amy. There we go. Sahara Desert. There. Verified.
Do you know what, Georgie? I could make you stuff to eat that's low calorie but still tastes the same.
Oh, no, 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 love. No, that's Morris's job. My food intake is carefully worked out by him. Anyway, I'm happy the way I am. Look at the joy that I bring to people.
Ha ha ha! Wax or gel?
Hey, oh! Hey, you've got that spot on. You're very good at this, Amy. It's very professional.
Janice's friend, Sunita, who works at Sunita's Scissors, has said she might give me a part-time job. And, like, if I'm any good, she's going to train me up and then I can...
Any good? You get Sunita's Scissors down here to have a look at that, eh?
Ah.
It's all psychology, Valerie. He said 7. I'm going in there at 7:15. Let him know I'm a busy man.
Oh, hang on. I've got a call, love. He's under the line.
Morris Morrissey, personal management. Morris speaking.
It's
all right, Morley.
Where are you?
No, running late. You know what it's like. I'm just in an important meeting. Visa George's media strategy.
I can see you.
What?
I can see you.
You can see me? Yeah, I'll be straight in.
Can I get you anything, Mr. Raisin?
Cafe latte, Clive. Bet you don't know what a latte is, do you, Morris?
Don't underestimate me, Morley. I'll have a cafe latte as well. Black. I've heard your dwarf's retired. That's another loss for you.
Once he passed 70, he couldn't do the cycling no more. Well, I've got another one coming through the ranks anyway. 2-foot hypnotist. Mini medium.
Well, if that's it, Morley.
How'd you explain that?
I don't know if it's escaped your notice, but you buried Tommy Stafford 6 months ago.
So that's the way you want to play it. See, that T-shirt is officially a lie.
Oh, yeah?
I got a fella down in Birmingham. I'm training him up. He's big.
How big is he? How big's big?
Big.
What's his name?
Brian.
Ooh.
Big Brian.
Big Brian.
Yeah, Big Brian. I've got plans for this one, Morris. Talented eater. I think he can go all the way.
He can go all the way up your ring piece, Morley. Georgie Godwin's the fattest man in Britain. That's it. End of.
We don't do black latte, sir.
You know what this means, don't you? Way off.
Why would Georgie Godwin do a way off? What's he got to prove? If I were you, I wouldn't let this fucking Big Brian humiliate himself.
A televised way off.
What do you mean, televised?
On the television, Morris. I had a word with Richard Bartler, he's up for it. Thinks he'd make a nice quirky one for the Tea Time Bulletin. Of course, if Georgie don't do way-offs...
Whoa. I didn't say he didn't do way-offs on the telly.
See you in. Grow up, Morris.
All right, on my way, Georgie. Things are intense. Hey, and I hope you're sitting down. Umbrella, Ella, under my umbrella. Ella, Ella. Come on, Georgie!
Tell me this, Amy. Why the fuck is that fucking Turk not fucking answering this fucking mobile?
Oh, now, come on now, Janice.
We've all been there, love. Amy's been there. I've been there.
Have you, Georgie? Who have you been there with?
I don't like to talk about it, love. It's still raw.
It were 8 years ago.
Bernadette. Irish girl. Born with a full set of teeth, she was, Amy. Can you imagine? She was one of my care assistants before Janice took over.
She never washed him properly.
She loved me very much, Amy. But I was mostly asleep in them days. And then they sorted out my medication and she went back to Ireland.
Stole his post office book.
Since that heartbreak, I've not bothered.
Well, it was Bernadette's loss, if you ask me.
No, it wasn't. It was George's. How much did you have in that book?
Amy, look, that's cat they're eating there. That's a little moggish.
Do you know what, Amy? In one whole year, all that fucking Turk's ever given me are 6-finger bowls. And they were from his restaurant.
Oh, come on, Janice. You're better off without him.
Oh, Emmy is so gorgeous, though. He never wears socks. Emmy, do you know how many times that Turk's let me down?
No.
Go on, guess.
I don't know. Lots.
Loads. And do you know where it by that? That man over there. That oversized man sat there in that chair is the only decent man in my life. He's always there for me. He's got an heart of gold. And do you know where it by that, Amy?
Under my umbrella, Ella, under my umbrella, What's up with you, Ponder Eyes?
The check's not rang off.
It's supposed to be our anniversary.
Well, maybe he's had to stop in and do his homework. Oh, come on, Janice, it's just a joke. Now then, Georgie.
We were visiting Acapulco.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Valmore Productions, I have an announcement to make. Take a good look at this man here, sitting in this corner of the room. Because on September 23rd, at 6:40 p.m, he's going to be in that corner of the room.
What do you mean?
You're going to be on the telly. Now, there are those that have doubted Valmore Productions. Well, to be honest, it was my Valerie. But, Georgie, this is it. Big time. We're going to do a live way-off.
A way-off?
It's against this lad called Brian. Big Brian from Birmingham. He's out of Morley Raisin Stable.
But everybody already knows I'm the fattest man in Britain. Why do I need a way-off?
Georgie, it's like Andy Wortle said. Everybody gets a 10 minutes of fame. Well, it's Georgie Godwin's turn. Listen, cock. We're going to bulk you up to beat condition. When you get on them scales, who knows? You may be the fattest man in the world.
Hey.
What are you on about? You can't bulk him up anymore. He's on oxygen as it is.
Listen, with all due respect, with the best will in the world, Amy, love, fuck off. It's nowt to do with you.
Of course it's as if I care about it.
And I don't.
No, it don't look like it.
Would you answer me one question, please, Amy? If I didn't care about him, how else do you think that fat lump sat there? How else do you think he would have met Edwina Curry? Eh? How else do you think he would have met Grant Bovey? Eh? Answer me that.
Georgie, I see you there, sat with that mask on at night, gasping away like it's your last breath. You need to lose weight, not put on any more.
Are you going to take this from her? Lose weight? Lose weight? His weight didn't bother you the night he asked you to move in, did it? When you had nowhere to go, orphan Annie.
Come on, now. She's only thinking about me.
I'm the one thinking of you, 24-7. It's all right, sat in that chair watching Andy Lambert with a fucking magnum and giving orders like Hitler.
I don't want any Viennettas anymore. I want Agandazzi now.
Never got me any. Still got me Viennetta.
I've said my piece, Georgie. If I say any more, I might regret it. I'll take Janice home before she's sick. We don't want to see that again, do we? Come on. I'll be round tomorrow, 12 p.m, noon. And then perhaps you can suggest what I'm going to say to Richard Barter. The fucking cheek of her, with a dyed black hair. And what's all this painting everything eggshell? It's just magnolia, Janice, for £5 a tin extra. Her in a fucking energy-saving light bulbs. What a load of cock. She's got herself up the duff, and now she's found a sugar daddy. She's exploiting him, Janice, because of his size. Are you all right, Janice? You're not going to be sick, are you?
George, Morris is your pimp.
I won't have you bad mouthing
him. He's just getting money out of people by showing you off like you're the... Elephant man!
If it wasn't for Morris Morrissey, I'd be living the life of an invalid!
It's happening! It's happening, Valerie! Oh, oh, bloody hell. I'm sorry, Janice, love. I lost my nerves for a moment there.
I've been called worse. Twice now. We've been making love. And the Turks call me Mama.
Me and Valerie. We're not even in the same bedroom now. She says it's because of me, you know me.
Snoring.
Psoriasis. Some nights, my elbows are on fire. But does she care?
Do you know something, Morris? I've never seen that Turk in daylight. He finishes at restaurant, comes over for his knockoff, and then he goes straight after. And I'm left with a bed full of hairs.
I've tried to get Valerie to come and see Georgie, take an interest in my career. But she says she can't stand looking at him. Makes her feel sick. Bloody hell, give us another go at them, Janice. It, Georgie, this is it. You're going to get on them scales a fat man, and you're going to get off a legend. Are you in the zone? Come on, get in the zone. Get in the zone. Think I'm a winner. I'm a heavy winner. Come on, say it, say it.
I'm heavy winner.
Come on.
I'm an heavy winner.
Come on.
I'm an heavy winner.
You've got it, you've got it. Hey, you haven't had a slash this morning, have you?
No.
Good. That's an extra £1 there. Marley's here. Yeah. There he is. Big Brian's here now. Is that it? You'll fucking walk this, Georgie. I've a bigger belly than him. Fucking hell.
Yeah? What?
Bring in Big Brian. Who's this? His anorexic fucking brother.
How are you, big Brian?
Nice to meet you, Georgie.
Here, come and sit here. That's you.
Oh, thank you.
Sit yourself down there, Brian. Save yourself the way off.
Like a towel, Big Brian. Would Big Brian like a towel?
We don't do towels, darling. Who's this stunner then, Morris?
This is Janice. She's part of Team Georgie.
Morley Razor.
Oh. Okay, guys. Hello there, and good luck to you both. Now, once the studio throws to me, I'll do a quick introduction. We'll get the first one on, weigh him, he can waddle off. Get the second one on, announce the winner, quick interview, always wanted to be fattest man sort of thing. Then it's Joan Cropper, her dance troupe, and we're out. Okay, any questions?
We're good to go, Richard.
Yeah, we're good to go, Richard.
Thank you, Richard.
Richard Barson's with them now. Richard.
Thanks, Claire. Joan Cropper and her troupe there, one of whom I'm reliably informed is her daughter. Well, regular viewers to the programme will
remember that the title of Britain's fattest man was held until recently by Burnley's two-ton Tommy Stafford, whose funeral we covered on this very show.
Here with me are two gentlemen hoping to claim that title for themselves. Rochdale's Georgie Godwin and Birmingham's Big Brian Porter. Well, this really could go either way. Big Brian,
you're first up on the scales, please. It's all very tense here, Claire. Behind Big Brian, there's his manager, Morley Raisin, who spotted Big Brian aged just 18 when he was stuck in the turnstiles at the Birmingham NEC.
We'll have the results any second now. And there it is. That is an incredible 54 stones and 6 pounds. That is amazing.
Nice one, Brian.
Well done, Big Brian.
Now on to our next contender, Rochdale's very own Georgie Bond.
Now I swear myself, I'm 53 and a half stone. And that was at J.K. Morley's on Ashcroft Road. They weighed me on the thingy that they wear the back.
Gonna have to hurry you there, George.
Oh, sorry, Richard.
So here we go, Georgie Godwin,
up on the scales.
Get in there, Georgie.
Me, Richard.
History in the making in the air, Claire.
Georgie!
Bated breath as we wait to see if George can top Big Brian's score.
42 stones
and 3 pounds. Yes. It's good, but it's not good enough.
What a result. Morley Raisin, Big Brian's manager, you must be delighted.
He's a very good boy.
Big Brian, let's have a reaction.
Yeah, delighted. In all fairness, I really enjoyed it.
So there you have it. By some 12 stones, Britain's fattest man, is Big Brian Porter from Birmingham. Back to you, Claire.
What a load of bollocks. I'd take afternoon off work for this.
42 stone? I've shit bigger than that.
Thanks, everyone. That's it. Really good human interest story. Thanks very much. Well done, Brian.
42 stone?
Now then.
I can't be! I'm with 53 at GK Morley on Ashcroft Road. I'm twice as sad as I was then. Look at me!
Richard!
Look at me!
We're not happy with the result. We want a recount.
Sorry, boys. You play with feathers, you get your arse tickled.
I suppose access might be a problem. We'll have to get him up in a...
I'll make us a cup of tea, Cock.
It's Little Dramas.
Well, thanks for your support. Morris says he's going to sort me out another way off. With the right scales this time. He said them ones must have been faulty. Danny says I was robbed. In any other spot there'd have been an inquiry. Edward Rowe, she said. Well, that's what she said.
They've made a right mess of the garden. Can I ask you a question, Georgie? How long is it since you've been outside this house?
None of your business.
It's not since your mum died, is it, George?
I've told you, Amy. I'm happy how I am.
Georgie, that's 23 years. What have you done to yourself?
Hey. In the lift at work. The sign said, maximum 16 persons. Underneath, someone had written, Ought One Georgie Godwin. No bugger would sit with me in the canteen. Not even Shaky Dave. And every day I'd get a straw for him for his soup and he still wouldn't sit next to me. And when I go out, I'd always get the same. Me chilling man. Mr. Wobbly, hey, you fucking fat twat! I heard him. Even when they said it quietly, I still heard him. And then along came Morris, with his enthusiasm and his panache, and suddenly people started to pay to see me. All right, they were mainly foreigners, but... But I didn't have to be ashamed about my size anymore. That's why this title is so important to me, Amy. The fattest man in Britain. Because I'm not the fattest, what am I, eh? I'm just a fat man. Just a big fat man sat in his chair.
You've already got a title, Georgie. You're my friend. I've never had a dad, but when I met you, it felt like I'd been given one. But that's shite because a real dad wouldn't eat himself to death in front of his daughter.
Amy.
Oh, fuck!
What is it? Is it happening, love?
How do I know?
Call an ambulance.
Right. Oh, hello, love. Ambulance, please. Yes, I think my friend's having a baby. Yes, right now. That is the correct address, number 42. Yes, ambulance is on its way, love. Oh, how many weeks gone are you?
28.
28? Oh, did you hear that? All right, 20. Well, we're not sure. Have you had a show? A show of what?
No.
No show yet. That's a no show. Do you feel like pushing? Because she's saying, if you do, don't. All right, love. Oh, thank you, love. Thank you. Ambulance is on its way, love. Right, now, let's get your baby bag. Come on. I tell you what, forget that. I'll just lie down here with you for a bit. Oh.
It's too early, Georgie. It shouldn't be happening yet.
Don't worry, love. I'm down here with you now and I shall stay here all the time. You are not alone, Amy. Hey, I'm a premature. Look at me. Why don't I sing you a little song here? Take your mind off it, eh? Hey, now, what can I get you from George's jukebox, eh? How about a bit of Neil Diamond?
No,
right. All right, then. Hang on. Right. Oh, here. What about this one? Moon River, wider than a smile, across...
It's mile.
You what?
It's wider than a mile, not smile.
What? How does that work? It isn't mile, it's smile.
I know that song, Georgie. I'm telling you, it's fucking mile.
Well, it don't make any sense to me. It's not, is it? drifters, off to see the world. There's such a lot of world to see. We're after, it's the same. Rainbow's end, waiting round the bend. That's it, my huckleberry friend. Moon River and me. Come on, again. Moon River, wider than a mile.
I'm crossing you in style someday. Oh, Lincoln, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters off to see the world. There's such a lot of world to see. We're after the same rainbow.
Hello! This is Georgie Godwin, fattest man in Britain. Please leave a message after the tone. Ha ha!
Georgie, love, it's me. Amy's fine.
Oh.
But she's lost the baby.
Oh, no. No.
It was a little boy.
No.
They tried, but they couldn't save him. I'm stopping with her for now and I'll not be home later, love.
And poor Babby. Poor little Babby.
Georgie, love! Oh, my God! Have you been here all night?
I told him to go. I said I'd be all right. How is she?
She's resting. Let.
Oh, don't.
Hello? Yes, hang on, I'm not sure. Georgie, do we need fire ambulance or please? We don't really know. We've got a 42 stone man here stuck on the floor.
53.
A 53 stone man stuck on the floor. Yes, Chapel Street, thanks. They're on their way.
When will she be home, Janice?
She's got to stay in hospital for another couple of days.
We need to get her home so we can look after her.
Yes, love.
Well, I'm going to tape all the Jeremy Kyles and she's going to rest on that sofa with her feet up whilst I run around after her.
Yes. Oh, Georgie, love, you must be parched.
Yeah.
I'll go and get you some cherry aid and a plate full of nibbles.
Can I talk to her, Janice? Will they let me speak to her? Eh? Eh?
Georgie, love, she asked me to give you this letter.
Oh.
Dear George, please don't worry about me. I will just have to get through this like I have a lot of other bad things in my life. They said at the hospital that the baby was too tiny for life. They let me hold him for a few minutes. I named him Georgie. I love you so very much. You are the kindest person I have ever met. But I won't be coming back, because I can't bear to sit by and watch you eat yourself to death. I've lost one, Georgie, and I don't want to lose another. I hope you will understand. Your friend, always, Amy. P.S. Smile is much better than mile.
Sorry about this.
People are worried about you, Georgie. I was there when Tommy breathed his last breath. Nobody ever enjoyed dying more. But at the end of the day, Georgie, he's still dead. Have you thought about God in any of this? I mean, hasn't God already got that big fat bastard Tommy up there already? He can wait a little while for another. And you can use that time to pull yourself together and with the help of God, fight this vicious disease of eating every feckin' thing. That's my blessing to you, Georgie.
Thank you, Father.
Georgie, if I may be so bold, and seeing as how you're not eating at the moment, could I have these Pop-Tarts? Father Brendan, he hides them on me in the sacristy. Miserable bastard.
Will you stop looking at that fucking window? Come on, Georgie. What's the matter with you? You've got to eat something.
Morris, I've told you. I don't want to do it no more. I'm sorry, but I'm not the fattest man in Britain. And I never was.
You are to me, Cock. You are to me.
Was planned. Who am I to ask you why you feel the way you do? If you feel the way you do, there must be something we could do.
You today, and it's not just me who says this, is the eighth wonder of the world. Touching will not be permitted under any circumstances. Health and safety. I can confirm to you that Georgie Godwin holds the world's record for Britain's biggest weight loss. And if anybody tells you that Big Brian from Birmingham has lost more, they're talking out their arsehole.
You and me, we're going stuck. Crackling Rose, your store-bought woman, but you make me sing like a guitar humming. So hang on to me, girl, our song keeps running. Play it now, play it now, play it now, my baby. Crackling Rose and make me a smile.
And the soundtrack to The Fattest Man in Britain by Badly Drawn Boy is out now, available on CD and download.
Set the world right. Find us a dream, but don't ask no questions. Yeah. Oh, I love my rosy child. You got the way to make me happy. You and me.
Aviva, retirement, investments, insurance for life's little dramas.